About Monster Squad or Troop Beverly Hills? Okay.
Or Dirty Dancing.
My favorite spot in Troop Beverly Hills is when she walks into the pool.
Peanut butter cookie time.
Oh, that's a good spot.
I've never seen it.
I love when she walks.
Ryan's also she's never seen Troop Beverly Hills.
Because he's
but
dead
you're
inside.
In love with Carla Gugino.
Well, I worked with her.
I go watch Troop Beverly Hills.
And The Haunting on Hill House.
Well, yeah.
I heard that was great.
All new stuff.
So good. So good. She's so good. My favorite part is probably the scene with me and Mary Ellen in my bedroom when she puts me to sleep. And I'm asking her about Sean getting in trouble. And she mistakes it for me questioning the marriage of my parents. Because it's just like a deeper level. And I loved working with her so much. And it was such a like quiet, sweet scene. So that's my favorite. Aside from, of course, like the big end, which is a blast.
You got one? I used to love just the scene when I shoot the Wolfman. Just because there's so much chaos going around my character, and I'm just sort of like kneeling down, and then a cop comes like rolling into me, and I grab his gun, pull the silver bullet, put it in, bang, shoot him. Then, I mean, everyone's favorite line is always, I'm in the goddamn club, aren't I? But if you watch that scene, it's now my favorite part, because if you go view it again, and I did not know I did this until like not that long ago, I actually like almost knock Andre on his ass as I'm walking away. You want to recreate it?
I'm in the goddamn.
Yeah, let's do
okay,
it.
We'll do that. Okay.
Let's do it. So
I'm such nerds.
Wait, I'll be here. I'm here. Okay. And you're going over there.
Wait, your favorite.
Yeah, I'm looking out here. Fine, we'll just do it right here.
Okay. So I'm at.
Yeah, you're here. Okay. Yeah.
They're doing the thing. They're talking to the thing. Blah blah blah. And I'm like, fuck it. And I put a cigarette in my mouth, and I go. And I just knock him right out of the way. I'm in the goddamn club, aren't I? And then I go off and kill kill all the monsters.
And that's how history's made.
Wait, I have a question. If you both could stay there, I feel like we need to go into like a Who's Line moment, and we need to do this scene a little differently.
Okay.
Can we play it out a little differently?
Okay.
Okay, so where are they located now? If it's not Monster Squad. No, we're doing this, guys. We're making this happen.
Oh, okay. I love it.
Okay, you're on
can
the
I
moon.
Play?
You're on the moon.
We're on the moon.
Okay, we're on the moon. And what's his motivation for the scene now?
Come on, you guys. Someone play. Yeah, you.
Okay,
you want the last slice of cake.
And where are they from? Or an accent of sorts. Japan. All right. You're on the moon. You can't do Japan? Okay.
That sounds like a little racist.
How about Southern? Can you do Southern?
Oh, yeah, okay.
Okay. Wait, you want the last?
Or it could be like.
I got it. Let's do it.
Okay. Scene.
It's my goddamn birthday, isn't it?
Way. Because of the 1/6 gravity, I'm flying further away than I should be. Where are you going, Rudy? Shh.
And scene. That was brilliant.
Cake.
Thank you for indulging in that weird moment. Round of applause for our actors, everybody. Thank you.
You guys are such fucking nerds.
And now do the lift. No, just kidding. God. It's fine. No, are you for real?
I'll barf.
No.
I'll probably barf.
one or both of them will die. We can't
do that. The secret is getting the hips, not the ribs.
It's in the hips. Secret's in the hips. What was the question again? Favorite scenes.
Oh, what was our favorite scene?
Yeah.
See what happens?
Sorry.
You said Mary Ellen. You said shooting Wolfman?
No, bumping you.
Bumping you.
Oh, bumping me.
Knocking you on your ass.
Oh, it used to be Wolfman. It's bumping me now. Obviously, I think we all start with like that. The final sequence is so gnarly. Because so much happens in that, and we were there, and it was just crazy. I think I like the scene between me and Stephen Mock. Like you and Mary Ellen, I think the scene between the father and son in the bathroom, because there's so much more going on there than just like, because we didn't even know monsters are about yet, right? And
both those scenes are just so grounded, I think.
Yeah, they could almost be, like, those are like scenes that could be in like, This Is Us Now, or something, right? Just some drama, family drama on network television. But it's a great scene. I think my favorite line in the movie is when Ashley off screen goes, "I heard he killed his dad," talking about Rudy. I was like, well, first of all, who would say that? And second of all, how do you know that? I love it.
I know everything.
I love it. But I think one of my favorite sequences is when Dracula pulls up and runs over my picket fence and is so pissed that he rips the back door of the hearse off one-handed. That just looks really cool to me.
I always really liked Duncan's walk towards me also, where he just like takes out all the cops without even flinching. With like the neck thing and that's like you just push it. It's an amazing like stride.
Yeah, no, it's not only amazing on him, but that's a really neat camera shot and
it's
one
really
long.
Really well choreographed.
It's really well done. Yeah. It's
good. Who asked the question? It was you that asked the question, right? What's your favorite scene?
Well, I just watched it last night.
For the first time, by the way.
I had watched it last night, especially after I watched the documentary. I don't know if I could pinpoint a favorite. There were so many good scenes, but with Ashley and the teddy bear, that tears, I got me.
I live to make people cry.
It gets everybody every time, right? Who's your favorite monster? Now that you've seen it. Yep. We did have the conversation of how steamy Dracula is, yes.
Yeah. Yeah, he's kind of a babe. And wait, who brought the toothbrushes? Was that you that brought
them,
toothbrushes? That was very kind.
Super thoughtful.
Any other questions? Because we still have a couple more minutes left, unless you guys want to act on any more scene. We still got about 5 minutes. Any questions? Anything at all?
No, actually. I've never had that question before. That's awesome. I just was repeating whatever Leonardo was saying, so I don't even think we practiced. They were like, no, it's more realistic if you just have to figure it out on the fly. So he just said it, and I repeated it.
Pro.
Any final questions? Well, any final thoughts from the three of you? Maybe, like, what's something about the three of you that the public doesn't really get to see?
I've been in bands since then. I've got a bunch of albums out there. One of the bands is called Elephone. The other band's called Kill Moi. I was in San Francisco for 15 years, so that's where that all came from. So yeah, that's what I've been up to for a while. I'm back in LA now, trying to get some projects off the ground, and we'll see what happens then. But if you want to like follow us, I always like update stuff. Ryan Lambert 111.
Not 1-1.
Nope. Yeah. There's three of them.
Well, because he left Twitter.
Right. I left Twitter.
On Instagram, it's Ryan Lambert 111.
Yes, three ones.
Don't forget the final one.
Yeah, well, what are the significance of the three ones?
I have no idea. That's so old because it was like my old like email was like something something 111. And that's like gave me like originally, like Yahoo.
At Netscape.
And it was like Yahoo or something, like an EarthNet or something.
Angel Fire.
Yeah.
Earthlink.
And then... So that just stuck. So it was always like round one.
Prodigy.
1-1-1.
Prodigy.net.
Yeah. Oh, God.
So I write and I act and I used to produce documentaries. People probably don't know that about me. I'm going to take this opportunity to plug my husband's show. My husband has a brand new television show premiering on the History Channel on January 8th at 10 p.m. called Project Blue Book. Which I've sort of been supporting him through working on for the last year. And it's a scripted show starring Aidan Gillen, who's Littlefinger from Game of Thrones, and Michael Mullarkey, who's Enzo on Vampire Diaries. And it's about the U.S. Air Force's final investigation into UFOs in the 1950s. So it's like X-Files in the time of Mad Men. And it's all based on real declassified cases from that era. And so it's awesome, and I'm super excited about it. The show's really great. Watch it, please, or at least DVR it and play it back when you're in the other room if you don't want to watch it so that it looks like people are watching it.
No, it looks great because it looks really well done, and I know they worked really hard on it because I can't wait for it because I saw the first promo and I was like, there it is.
It's very exciting.
And it's not even my project. I just know some the people that are doing it. And I'm into UFOs in the 50s. So I think what was the question? Like something that most people might know about us since they only know us as Monster Squad? I'm from LA, but I have a lot of family roots in North Carolina. And I've always been a basketball fan and basketball, always been an athlete and athletic and jumping around on things. But I always wanted to play basketball in college. And so I left the entertainment biz for a number of years and actually went to play college basketball in North Carolina. So that's something that a lot of people don't know about me.
I had no idea.
Yeah, there you go.
All right. So anything else you guys want to plug before we have to wrap it up?
What was the documentary called?
It's called Wolfman's Got Nards.
That's right. And if anybody's on the social media stuff, like the interwebs, follow it at The Squad Doc. And we always post kind of BTS stuff or updates. We just finished kind of our six-month film festival run that was basically on all sides of the planet for about 6 months. And right now we're in kind of the distribution release schedule, figuring it out phase. So hopefully in the next couple of months, at The Squad Doc, we'll give you sort of the updated of where you can see it, where you can buy it, where what theater it may be playing in, what streaming service it may eventually go to. So cool. Please stick, stay tuned to that, and because we want you to see it.
Awesome. Woohoo!